Hello everyone, this is Bitcoin Sofia and today I want to talk about the HODL strategy. HODL is a dumb strategy. I'll explain exactly why, but before I do, I want to specify that there are actually two types of HODL. Basically, first, what's HODL? HODL is the strategy of buying a bunch of cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, for example, BTC, and hoarding it, keeping it with you until it becomes more expensive, then selling. And there are two types of HODL. There is the type where you expect good things. You expect growth in the economy. You expect merchants everywhere accepting Bitcoin, accepting transfers, accepting buys, purchases with Bitcoin. And when so many people use Bitcoin, the price will obviously be up because of all the economic activity that is happening with Bitcoin. Bitcoin will represent so much wealth that it's obviously going to be worth more. The second type of HODL is when you expect bad things to happen. And that is, for example, the expectations that the USD, the United States dollar, is going to collapse. And the idea is that if it collapses, all the people are gonna rush into Bitcoin and buy and use, because they'll have no choice. These are the two types of HODL. Good things, bad things. Both are dumb. I'll explain the bad one first. The bad expectation of bad times is not a new strategy. This has been employed a lot in ancient China by rich merchants who would buy all the rice and would hoard the rice into their private reserves. And when winter came, because winter is that expectation of bad times, there is no rice during winter. So winter comes, the fields are empty, people are hungry, and the merchant starts selling the rice at an expensive price. This is HODL. This is HODL. This is how HODL works. And the reason it doesn't work is because the same merchant can actually earn more money by not doing that. There is a thing in economics called opportunity cost. It's a quite simple concept. Opportunity cost basically means the price, the value that you could have earned if you did something else. For example, if you can create a painting and sell it for $100, or create a statue and sell it for $200, and both cost you the same resources and time, obviously it's better to create the statue. If you create the painting instead of the statue, you get $100 instead of $200. And the difference between these two prices is the opportunity cost. You missed an opportunity, and the cost of that missing the opportunity is $100, the difference. And there is an opportunity cost to hodling rice. Basically, these merchants could have earned more by selling the rice early, getting more money early. Technically, they would get less than they would get in the winter, but they would get it much earlier. And they would buy something else and sell it again, and buy something else and sell it again. And at the end, because they missed all that chance, they lose money in opportunity cost. They could have earned so much more than they did. That's why hodling and waiting for worse is bad. And then there is the other thing. If you're waiting for something worse, something bad to happen, if you're waiting for bad environment where people will be forced to buy your thing. What if it doesn't come? What happens if good stuff comes instead of bad? What happens if, for example, people discover potatoes and they start eating potatoes instead of rice? Or using Bitcoin SV instead of BTC? Who would have thought? Then you're stuck with all that rice, which is now useless. It's not useless, but it's cheap. It's cheaper than you bought it for. because potatoes actually grow even during winter. So obviously this is a bad strategy. It loses money even if you are correct, but if you're wrong it loses much more. Then what about the expectation of good times? Obviously, again, we can say the same thing. What if the good times don't come? What if the usage of that thing does not grow? And in here I cannot compare this type of hodl to the hodl of rice. I can compare this type of hodl to the hodl of stocks. Some people buy stocks of random companies or stocks of a specific company that they like, and they expect something really good to happen. And there is a problem with that. Both with stocks and with Bitcoin HODL, when you expect good stuff, you need to do stuff. Just investing into a company does not automatically make that company better. It just means that you own a percent of it now. So what? If instead you take these stocks and become a stakeholder, a proper stakeholder, a person who makes decisions in the company, a person who pushes the company in the right direction, then your investment is protected by yourself. You actually work towards making your investment better. And it's the same with Bitcoins. Honestly, it's exactly the same. Now, Bitcoin is obviously not a company. It's not something you can have stocks of. But you can have a fixed percentage of the supply. First, and second, if you want it to grow in price, you can help that. You can build stuff, you can build solutions, you can make a business with Bitcoin. And there is a problem with that, that these HODL people don't really want to work. They want to HODL, not to work. Work helps the currency grow because it's economic activity. And the good times that these people are expecting, the good outcome, is economic activity. That's what they're expecting. They're expecting economic activity that makes the price go up. At least the optimists. I already spoke about the pessimists. So obviously, doing economic activity will help having economic activity. But the strategy of HODL is not that. The strategy of HODL is taking money away from the activity, keeping it for yourself and waiting. That is not a smart strategy. What are hodlers doing when they need to buy stuff? Do they use Bitcoin? Hell no. Hell no. Even if they buy something with Bitcoin right now, they would immediately take a bunch of US dollars or euro or whatever and buy the same amount of Bitcoin and put it back in their wallet, because they don't want to change the amount. So did they just spend Bitcoins or did they just spend dollars? They transacted in Bitcoins, but they spent dollars. That is not economic activity. Now, some people would say, but if you spend your Bitcoins, you're not gonna have them. Not if you're a business. Businesses have this wonderful thing called profit. Profit. That means spending and getting more than you spent. It's that simple. These businesses help cryptocurrencies. These businesses help companies as well. If you're a stakeholder or something like that, just work. And that's why HODL is a dumb strategy. It just is. Now, another comparison I can give you for HODLing. I believe HODLing is the strategy of the blood leeches. You know, these small worm-like creatures that live in the water, that attach to you and start sucking your blood away. These guys. Basically, I see HODLers as leeches who are attached to the Bitcoin economy, taking away some of the blood, so that they can be richer later, so that they can have more of the nutrition when it's actually needed. But they're not helping it. Now, do you need to help Bitcoin? Should you help Bitcoin? Hell no! Hell no! Bitcoin is a tool. You should not be helping it. You should be using it. If it's useful to you, use. If it's not, throw it away. That's why I tell people, either make businesses or get the fuck out. Users as well. Users should only use it if it's useful, if it saves them money. Money. If it doesn't, then what the hell are they doing with it? If it doesn't give them new opportunities to do stuff they didn't do before, or gives them the opportunities to do the same stuff cheaper, if it doesn't do either of these two, then throw it the fuck away. It's useless, it's shit. HODL is dumb. Business is good. Cost effectiveness is good. Bye bye.